gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen and Pony Club members, thank you all so much for coming this evening. We're delighted that Pony Club has been able to put this event on this evening. It's a wonderful event to celebrate the achievement of an exceptional young lady who we are all incredibly proud of.
I look into the window of my mind. Reflections of the fears I know I've left behind. I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascend.
Please give the biggest, warmest welcome to double Olympic gold medalist, the only person to have ever won every British youth title, and recent Blenheim winner, and our very own superstar, Miss Yasmin Ingham.
We've got mum's time.
What a welcome.
Wow, that was amazing. Like,
let mum recover for a minute.
I know.
So, Yaz, it's been an absolutely incredible 6 years since you've left the Isle of Man. And you've come back, Blenheim winner. Have you come back down to earth yet?
No, like it still feels like so surreal that it's even happened. Just like the past 2 weeks, I've just been like found myself looking back at all the pictures and watching the videos again, sort of just reliving all of those emotions. It's just like that moment was something that you kind of just dream about. And to have all the lovely videos to watch back just makes it so special that I've kind of got those memories forever.
Yeah, it's fantastic. And Banzai has really won all our hearts here on the Isle of Man. So not only are you both Blenheim winners, but last year you rode him to victory in the 8 and 9 year old championship at Burnham Market. So it must be a really great achievement and so proud of yourself to prove him at that level.
Yeah, I mean, I've since day one, we've all known that he's such a special horse and with a massive future, but it's just kind of connecting all the dots and putting all the pieces in place. And it's just amazing that he's coming together now. I mean, we're still not quite there yet with a few things, which is makes it even more exciting for the future. But just to have that win last year at Burnham Market and then to sort of continue it on to Blenheim, yeah. Was really special, and I think actually Nicole Brown from Equa Racing said that it's don't think it's been done before, which is quite pretty
another
cool.
Achievement.
Yeah, so that was nice to sort of go on from the 8 and 9 year olds onto the 4 star long at Blenheim. So
yeah, brilliant. So you obviously are super talented, and but we're not taking any of that away from you. But you do obviously say yourself, you have a super team behind you. What kind of effort goes into getting a result like Blenheim?
Wow, it's just, it takes an army to even like get to that point. I mean, I've got the most incredible owners in Sue and Jeanette, so I'm so grateful for them for all their support. Obviously my home team around me, I've got Alison, Owen and Denise who help me every day on the yard. So it takes a small army, and I think that a lot of people only see like the tip of the iceberg sometimes. Yeah. So it's like what goes on beneath the ocean that people don't see. It's like highs and lows and lots of setbacks, and you just got to pick yourself up and get back on. And then when you have a moment like winning at Blenheim and having those really amazing wins, it does make all of the hard work and early mornings and long days like worth it. So I'm so grateful to all of them guys for helping me.
And we're delighted to have Sue Davies here with us tonight. And on behalf of the Isle of Man Equine community and Pony Club, we'd like to say a massive congratulations on your Blenheim victory. So before we go any further, let's have a little look at Banzai's performance at Blenheim.
You're like a sunshine, only giving good vibes anytime that you're rolling. Pulling me out, never letting me down, and I want to make sure you know it. You're like a sunshine, only giving good vibes anytime that you're rolling. Can't believe that I found my sunshine. Hey, everyone's trying to be the same. Till I met you, I was on that way. But you really are something different. You do you, it must be nice. And I think it's rubbing off on me. Oh yeah, step to the left, step to the right. Do what you want. What really matters is the journey that we're on. Yeah, riding with you, I finally know where I belong. I belong. You're like a sunshine, only giving good vibes anytime. I need it.
Now, to us, a full perfect performance, but I bet you're sitting there going, oh, I could have done that bit better, because I know you're a perfectionist.
Yeah.
And to finish on that fabulous dressage score was phenomenal.
Yeah, I mean, it was an amazing score. I actually came out of the arena kind of a little bit disappointed with a few things. As you said, I'm just like such a perfectionist, and I just find every little part of the test that I feel like could have gone better. And there was just a few moments that I feel like I could have maybe done this or that, or it could have been better, or rode for extra marks. But to come out with such an amazing score, and to go into the jumping phases with, you know, to be on the top of the leaderboard is really exciting, because I know that the jumping phases are sort of my better phases. So it was definitely nitpicking, but nice to know that there's lots to improve for the future, and there's lots more in there, I think, that he can give and I can give, and as a partnership we can improve over time. So that's very exciting.
I think everyone can relate to the fact when they come out of a dressage test and go, oh, that was rubbish.
I don't think I've ever come out of a dressage test.
But what
going,
did you say to Chris Bartle?
Yeah, I came out to Chris Bartle, who does a lot of training with me, and he just said, oh, Yaz, you know, that could have been better, couldn't it? And I was like, yes, I know. And
so watch out, what's going to happen next? Like, if we can produce that.
Yeah, it was nice to know that he sort of thought that there was definitely a sort of 21, 22 at least
in there. Yeah.
So it's definitely a case of just working towards that now for the future. And we sort of stood outside the arena waiting for the score to come in, and it did come in the end and went ahead of Piggy by something like 0.7. So I think he was quite chuffed with that as well.
Yeah. He cheered up. Yeah. That's fab. And how on earth did you control those nerves going into that last show jumping phase?
I think when you have such like a pressurised situation, you've just got to think that this is kind of what you've been training for the whole time. Yeah. Like, you kind of relate to go back and when you've been jumping grids in the outdoor or like doing some exercises in the school, like it's all working up to this point. And I think another huge part is definitely Chris Bartle is sort of a massive like security blanket for me in some ways. Like, he'll work me in for the show jumping, and I remember we were sort of, came down to the last five in the warm-up arena. There was me, Piggy, Roz, Susie Berry, and they were all obviously disappearing out, going into the ring, and by this point it was getting a little bit more stressful. And they had to slow us down a bit because they were ahead of time on the horse and country, so we had to wait a little bit, and he just said to me, just stop and just stand still and just chill and don't put pressure on yourself, just relax. And we just had a little chat about just random stuff. Yeah, it was nice. It just completely took my mind off it. So to have him there and just like saying that he believes in me and, you know, this is what we've worked towards. And yeah, he's definitely a huge part of that sort of pre going into the ring and just relaxing. And there's lots of techniques that he uses as well, like before the dressage. He just said, just give him a little pat behind the saddle, you know, just like tell him to chill out, just relax. You know, you haven't gone into the ring yet, so you can relax, just pat him and just make him relax. And it definitely does work. So, yes, huge thanks to him for chilling me out.
Yeah. And what about the horse and hound cover?
Whoa, I mean, that was
Did you know about it?
No, I didn't know. So, like, to kind of have that, or I'm not sure, someone sent me a picture of it first thing on Thursday morning, like, you're on the cover, and it's something that like you kind of grow up dreaming about. And to have that as the cover after Blenheim was just so special, and it's on my wall in my flat and in the house, so it's so nice that we can always sort of look back to that and think, wow, what an amazing time. And yeah, it's obviously, it was a beautiful picture in front of a very iconic event. So,
and I'm sure you'll
amazing.
Sign a few while you're at home.
Oh, yeah.
So we're really lucky to have you here tonight, and thank you so much for coming back to do this. What have you been up to while you've been back?
To be honest, I've just been like catching up with family and friends, been out for a couple of walks. So it's been really nice because I haven't been back since like January time. So just really just seeing everyone, my friends, family, and just catching up on some sleep.
Now, what I want to know is, has Mum kept on top of the carpet organisation?
Yeah.
Tell everybody about your carpet.
My carpet? Oh, my God.
You have to hoover it in a certain...
Yeah, it's got to be hoovered in stripes. So I don't know if people can relate to that or not, but, like, I've got this little shark hoover that I can do, like, lines with, and it just... It makes me happy. There's the little things in life that just...
Mum said you had to go and sort that out before you came home.
Oh, yeah, like, when I left the UK, my flat, it's perfect. It has to be, like, all clean and stuff, so...
Right, so, ladies and gentlemen, there's plenty more to come. We're going to have a meal now, and then we're going to come back after our meal and talk a lot more. This evening, we have some fabulous raffle prizes that Yaz's sponsors have donated a few, and we have some other people that have donated some raffle prizes, such as some rugs and unusual bit and steam packet vouchers. So all sorts. So make sure you get your raffle tickets when they come round. We also have, if you look at the back there next to the canvases, there's a framed photograph of Banzai at Blenheim. Yaz will sign that this evening, and if you put £5 in your envelope, you'll go into a draw to win that. So the envelopes are all on the table. And also this evening, at the very, very end, we're going to do some questions. So if you've got a question that you'd like to ask Yaz that I don't cover in the interview, if you just jot it down on the pieces of paper that are left on your table and bring it to my mum and dad's table, then they will... What, wave, mum? Then they will... they don't know who they are. Then they'll put it in the little pot and we'll talk about them later. So hopefully you'll enjoy your meal and we'll be back after. Thank you. Got a drink in the back.